We're having a service at the work, partly because some people feel it's more appropriate at a time when people cannot join in physically with the communion, but also it's going to give Chris a Sunday off as part of his well-deserved rest. This Sunday begins the week of prayer for Christian unity. And unfortunately, we can't have a physical service to remember the week of prayer for Christian unity, which we were going to host here at St. Thomas later on in the week. But instead, we have put on our website, and it will be going on the Facebook page, a meditation which I would urge you to have a look at during the week. That's also gone out to the other churches in St. Anne's. So now let us set our minds upon our Lord and Heavenly Father. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in peace with all. In a moment of silence, we recall our shortcomings before God. We confess, Heavenly Father, that we have not loved you and trusted you with our whole hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We confess that we have not always loved our neighbours as ourselves. We have not always remembered that the members of all Christian churches are our beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, and that all people are your beloved little children. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We confess that we have often loved ourselves in proud and selfish ways, and not humbly as your beloved little children. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say together the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer, for you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the most
the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now, Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again, a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go, lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We sang together the response at the beginning, the middle, and the ending of the psalm. "Search me out, O God, and know my heart. O Lord, you have searched me out and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thoughts from afar. You mark out my journeys and my resting place, and are acquainted with all my ways. For there is not a word on my tongue, but you, O Lord, know it altogether. You encompass me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, so high that I cannot attain it. Search me out, O God, and know my heart. For you yourself created my inmost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I thank you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, my soul knows well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my fall as yet unfinished. Already in your book were all my members written, as day by day they were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them. How deep are your counsels to me, O God? How great is the sum of them? If I count them, they are more in number than the sand, and at the end, I am still in your presence. Search me out, O God, and know my heart. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Hear the The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you come to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe me because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This morning, we're given examples in our readings of God revealing himself to a variety of people, making himself known to them, calling them to follow, giving instructions to a young Samuel, to Philip, to Nathanael. It's inspiring what we're told and shown. And it is so often easy to say, "Well, that happened then. It's not for now. Or could it really happen to me?" Did we, at this time of Epiphany, are called to realize the wonder of Emmanuel, God with us, a reality here and now? Take time now and reflect. Think about a time, past or even now, when you felt you were being led or directed on a particular path or direction by God. It could be something large or small. But it was a real time of revelation. Could be a result of a gentle nudge that won't go away, leave your mind, or a real significant light bulb moment. Might not have been easy to understand. Then wrestling, needing to work through, or to have the help and wisdom of others in understanding, like the Samuel and the Nathanael. Could be absolutely clear. For example, when I first came to this church of St. Thomas, first service I came to, it was obvious to me that this is where God wanted to be. It could just evolve over time and testing, involvement in certain areas of ministry. Or it could be certain direction. Like the people who knocked the home start island, as it was. Or people getting together when they formed the drop-in centre in St. Anne's. As a Christian united group. Or words that come from a time of prayer, or maybe even just out of the blue, that we text and work through. Looking for some form of confirmation in one way or another. I can't believe that it was just over a year ago that in the congregation two people were confirmed, two adults, and that hadn't felt right for them at the time. Another step on their journey. One of my favourites, that we are known by God, loved by God individually, and as such, the way God relates and speaks to us, shows himself to us, is individual, like any relationship we have. If we believe, though, in such a wonderful and loving God, and if we say in the Lord's Prayer, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven," then we are opening ourselves to follow him. Thy will be done. And to be transformed to the person we are created to be. To be open and vulnerable. Listening, seeking, and trusting. It isn't always easy or straightforward. And it's not deemed in success, as maybe the world would define it. God calls us to follow and show his love in the world to others, in whatever way that may be. It's like in a word to the hymn that Mandy played as we came in, and I know we're on Facebook. The last verse says this: "Lord, your summons echoes true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go. Always where your love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow in you and you in me." Amen.
Now let us affirm our faith in the God who loves us, calls us, and is always with us. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father. now our intercessions.
Father, in this time of great difficulty in the world, when it's easy to feel anxious and overwhelmed, help us to be open to your message of hope and joy, even when things are tough, to know that you are Emmanuel, God with us, and to show and share that love with others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for your church all over the world in this week of prayer for Christian unity. May all the churches be united by your Holy Spirit in our faith and uphold us by your bond of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, in the situation in the world today, we pray for those countries where there is no peace, where there is bitterness and division. We pray particularly for the United States of America, with its new president being inaugurated this week. For Uganda, with the turbulent elections that have just taken place. For the countries in the Middle East, where there seems no peace. We pray for your peace, reconciliation between people and nations. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our own country, for our leaders at national and local level, for those in the public services and other organisations at this difficult time. Guide them in all the decisions they make, that they may be for the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Following our weekly prayer diary, we include in our prayers those who live in Victoria Road and York Road. For your blessing on our licensed lay ministers and for Christian unity here in St. Anne's, giving thanks for all that the organisation does in this place. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, at this time when there seems much fear and sickness, we remember those who are sick in body, mind or spirit and in need of our prayers. Particularly we think of Eileen Metridge, Janet Biancini, Julie Bouquet, Nicola Cunningham, Fran Davis, Francis Duggar, Judith Eastwood, Marion Fielding, Jesse Finch, Gloria and John Gibson, Jane Greenhalgh, Martin Greer, John Hare, Anne Hewlett, Shirley Jackson, Eileen McGuckin, John McGuckin, June Medley Cott, Hilary Myers, Sylvia Nicholas, Heather Pasco, Anthony Rayner, Pat Rayner, Catherine Roberts, Roy Simpson, June Thompson, Sarah, and baby Izzy. And any known to us, we name in our hearts before you. May they know your comfort, your healing, and your peace, O Lord. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we bring before you, Lord, and remember before you those who have died. May they rest in your peace. Particularly think of Jill Burbage and Robert Percival. And we ask your comfort and blessing on all those family and friends who grieve. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Almighty God, in Christ you make all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace. And in the renewal of our lives, make known your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May, in these troubled times, the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.